entering the transaction code in the command field. To create a transaction, we need to follow these 8 steps. First, in the object navigator, we're going to display the object list for your program. Then, in the navigation area, we're going to use the context menu of the program to choose create more transaction. We're going to enter the required transaction code. We assign a short text. We enter the name of the program for the transaction and we choose professional user transaction. Under GUI enable, we set the indicator SAP GUI for Windows. We save the transaction and finally we assign it to a package. So let's log on to our SAP system. Let's activate an object and let's create a transaction. So we navigate to our object navigator. And then we navigate to our package. Let's make sure we are inside our Z ABAP course package. Inside our ABAP package, we're going to create a new program. This is just going to be a simple program just to show you how to activate an object. So we right click on our package, we select create and we select program. And we write Z test 2 in this case because we already had a Z test in our program. We are gonna uncheck this little option and then we are gonna click OK. Our program is gonna be called just program Z test 2. Yeah, we're gonna leave that and we're gonna save. Remember that we always have to assign our programs to a package, so the system is asking for us for a package. So we tell them it is our Z ABAP course package and we save it. The system presents an error. So we get this error and we can fix it. That is because we have an option checked in our package. So let's click OK for the error and let's go back. Let's cancel this for now. Yes, I want to cancel. Now, we go to our package and we double click our package. Then we get these options here. We need to uncheck this and this option so we can create objects in our package. So we click the edit mode. Then we uncheck main package and we press enter. Now we uncheck package not extendable and we press enter. We save now. Our object was saved. Now we can create a program in our package. So we create a program, the test without top include, and we click OK. We select the number, the name, the package, we click save, and now we assign it to a change request. We're gonna change assign it to our ABAP training course. So let's just write a simple ABAP program just to try to activate our object. So we're just gonna write a simple print to the screen hello world program. That's it. So remember, whenever we activate an object, 3 things are executed. Our object is saved, our syntax is checked, and then a runtime object is generated. We can do those 3 steps manually. First, we save our program, then we check our syntax, and now we activate the program. Our work list is displayed. We select our object and we activate it. That's how we activate objects. Now let's create a transaction for our recently created program. So to create a transaction, we go back to our object navigator. So we click back. Back in our object navigator, we navigate to our program, and in this case ztest2. We right click, we select create, and we select transaction. Here we write our transaction code. Remember that all of our objects need to start with the letter Z, so we write Z, and let's just give it a code. Let's start with 01 code. So let's use 001, a short text for a transaction. This would be just a transaction test. And we select program and selection screen for report transaction, because this is our report. So we click OK, continue. We type our program for this transaction now. It's gonna be ztest2. We want the transaction assigned to this program. We select professional user transaction, and we select SAP GIF for Windows. And we save our transaction. And our transaction code was saved. We can view our transaction by double clicking on it in the object navigator. We can use our transaction to call our program and execute it. How do we do this? We go back to the SAP Easy Access menu. We use the yellow arrow to go to that menu. We exit. Now we type our transaction and we press enter. Our program is executed successfully.